Fabulous morning, my dear children. Welcome to Gurudev online class. Hope you have understood what I taught in previous class. Today, let me get into the new concept. That is page number 70, sixth paragraph. In previous class, we have discussed up to five paragraph. Now is the time to get into the new paragraph. Here, in sixth paragraph, first I read it, just follow me up. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had a clear perception of mutuality of three pillars of the state, that is the legislature, executive and judiciary. He realized that the jurisdiction of each should be clear and untrammeled. At the same time, he had a sense of importance of role of citizens. The following observation he made is significant. The Constitution is a fundamental document. It is a document which defines the position and powers of the three organs of the state, the executive, the judiciary and the legislature. Here, it is also defines the power of the executive and power of the legislature as against the citizens. As purpose of constitution is not merely to create organs of state but to limit their authorities. Because if no limitation was imposed upon the authority of organs, there will be complete tyranny and complete oppression. Yes, in sixth paragraph, here Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had a clear perception about the mutuality of three organs. Dear children, I hope you have learnt in the 6th standard or 7th standard about the organs, the main three government organs, right? So which are those? Yes, absolutely. That is legislature, executive and judiciary. Here, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had a clear perception, means he is well known about all these sectors. These are called as the organs, constitutional organs, that is legislature, executive and judiciary. Here Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had a clear perception, means he is good at all these organs. Yes, he had a great knowledge towards executive, legislature and judiciary. So what does it mean? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had referred many other foreign constitutions. Later he came to know that the organs of these three constitutions, and also they mentioned that these all called as the pillars of Indian constitution. I hope I need not explain. In previous social you have studied all these organs and the main work of legislature, executive and judiciary. Okay, so briefly I tell you, the legislature, it is nothing but it legislates the constitution. For example, if they want to be bring any change in the constitution or if they want to be make any new law, then we go with the legislature. It is main point to create laws in Indian constitution. Okay, and executive. What is the work of executive? So before, legislature have creating different laws, this executive, the work of this executive is, it will be exhibit the laws. For example, I give an example for this. See, 371J, I think you know that. 371J, it is an article, it has given modified in the Hyderabad Karnataka region. It has been gone under the backward. There are several reasons. So that is why Indian constitution has given separate reservation to the Hyderabad Karnataka districts, right? Under the 371J, it is modified and brought into under the legislature. Okay, this executive made it to exhibit in Hyderabad Karnataka. Judiciary, the meaning of judiciary is here. So it comes under all fair, justice, whatever the work of justice, court, laws and articles, it is notifying that. I hope you got all the points about legislature, executive and judiciary. Here Dr. B.R. Ambedkar has clear perception, ability to see all these things. He had a great clear perception. you try to understand, it is very difficult to understand. So that is why I am repeating. Okay, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had a clear perception, ability to see the three organs of the Indian Constitution. Those are legislature, executive and judiciary. Later, he raised that the jurisdiction of each should be clear and untrammeled. The jurisdiction, again he spoke about judiciary. Jurisdiction, the meaning of jurisdiction is, it is the one thing which gives a fair or justice in right way. That Kannada is called as Nyaya Nirnaya. Okay, jurisdiction. Again he raised and he told about jurisdiction. This jurisdiction, Nyaya Nirnaya, should be clear and untrammeled. Untrammeled, the meaning of untrammeled is not restricted. It has to be restrict this jurisdiction. Okay, there are many influences. Either he may be a politician or he may be a somebody else. Okay, for example, if I am a culprit, if I was arrested by the police, then by some influence I may release. But it is not good. Under the jurisdiction, it has to be clear and it is untrammeled. It is not restricted. Nobody should restrict it. Okay. Everybody equal under the law. He raised and he told about this. And also he had a sense of importance of role of citizens. Okay. So when he made all these organs and jurisdiction, whatever it, also he considered the citizen of India. Right? For example, you know already the King John V was a dictator. Right? He made his own law. Whatever he do, that is a final and it is ultimate. But what Ambedkar made all these legislature, executive and judiciary, what they have imposed, you know, law and order to the citizens, he remembered the sense of people. Okay, it should not be restricted anything, right? If they are imposed in Indian Constitution, we should not speak with anybody, in other words, what it is. Right? So that is why he made, we have right to equality. We have right to speak. I can speak with anybody. I may speak within parliament meeting because I have a power. It is given by Indian law. That is legislature, executive and judiciary. Right? So he remembered Indian citizen and he made all these things. The following observation he made is significant. So what I am telling now, those are important, significant, he observed in Indian Constitution. See, Constitution is a fundamental document. It is a fundamental document. It is a document which defines the position and the power of the three organs of the state, that is executive, judiciary, legislature. Yes, as I have written on board, Indian Constitution. Constitution is a fundamental document, a base document to a particular country. Indian Constitution is base document to the Indian citizen. The meaning of this statement is everybody, the citizens of India want to be followed. That is called as fundamental document. Fundamental, we may take it a fundamental rights, fundamental needs, whatever it, we have to be followed. It is a fundamental thing which has to be followed by Indian citizen. It is a base. So now our jurisdiction or our justice based on fundamental document. Next, this fundamental documents is defines the position and powers of the legislature, executive and judiciary. See, this fundamental document, what we call as constitution, it defines the position and power of the legislature, executive and judiciary. Position and power, if we come to the matter of position and power, see, if I am a teacher, I have a different position, right? I have different duties, I have different powers I may impose on the children, right? In a right way, it has been given to the a particular person or particular organ. As like that, legislature, it has its own position and power, and executive, it has own its position and power, and judiciary, it has own its position and power. Okay, and although he told, It also defines the powers of the executive and the power of the legislature as against the citizens. As we have done in our chapter dealing with the fundamental rights, I think in 6th standard political science you have studied dealing with the fundamental rights. I know, I think you know all those fundamental rights, 6 fundamental rights are there. So here we need to concentrate on that. So Indian citizens, we are the one who are following fundamental rights and as well as fundamental duties. So whenever we get into the different difficulties, suddenly we raise our voice because we have 6 rights. Right to equality, right to education, educational remedies. There are 6 fundamental rights. We need to get into that. Okay. So here it has imposed different powers and positions to the executive and as well as legislature. In fact, the purpose of constitution is not merely create organs of the state but limit their authorities. You have to be keep one more thing in your mind that constitution is not only merely create the organs. You never think that the work of Indian constitution is not given power to all these organs. Not only merely not only given power to all these organs, that is legislature, executive and judiciary, including that it has to be control their authorities. Control their authorities. The meaning of control their authorities is if constitution has given fully power to all these organs, the people are the officers who are working under this, they may misuse their authority. For example, if I am a prime minister, I should not go with the illegally, right? I have to be go whatever amendment I do it, I have to be go legally. But if constitution has given me power to do anything, I could have done anything what I want, right? There are some limitations. Okay, so there is a boundary. We should not go beyond the limits. We have to be work under the limits. Here Ambedkar did this. Okay, it has put some boundaries. Within that boundary, we have to be carry our work. Because if no limitation was imposed upon the authority of organs, there will be completely tyranny and completely oppression. Yes. Here, you just think a few seconds. If Prime Minister or if a CM, Chief Minister of a state, get fully power, if there will be no boundary to their work, then it will be beyond the limit. We could not be control them. They do whatever they want. They may sell kotru to other country. It is possible because every power have been imposed them. Nobody ready to control them. As so that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar made a plan, he imposed some boundaries. They have to be work under the boundaries. If they carried or if they not imposed the boundary, it is completely tyranny. The meaning of tyranny is here cruelty. Okay, that will be called as it may be a dabbaliki, right? And also oppression means it will be ghost rule. It may be ghost rule. Then they may be not under the control and they carries their rule however they want. It may be called as anarchy. Okay. Next, Jawaharlal Nehru chose Dr. Ambedkar to be the first law minister of the independent India. This was a recognition of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's skills in the field of law and legislation, as also tribute to his vision of social justice. A vision which was sought to be the infused into the new Indian polity. But above all, this was a tribute to success of Baba Saheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's own campaigns against the social justice. Who could have dreamt that one born to Meher family would one day become not only a law minister but lawmaker and be aired as modern man? Yes, here Jawaharlal Nehru, he has chosen Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as their first law minister. You think over it, he is not in the Congress, although Jawaharlal Nehru chosen him as a first law minister of India. What would you think about now, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar? Because Nehru and other people of Indian government during that time, they came to know that the quality and the knowledge of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So that is why they have chosen Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as their first law minister of Indian independence. We have to be proud about this, right? This was recognition of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's skill in the field of law and legislation as also tribute to his own vision for social justice. We have to be think over it. This recognition shows that he had a great skills in the field of law and legislation. Law and legislation. The meaning of legislation is maker. He is not a law minister. He is a lawmaker. We came to know that he had a great perception of and he had a great knowledge about, you know, legislation. Legislation. Okay. Making the laws. It is not a small matter that because the meaning of law is very difficult. The inner meaning, the depth meaning of law is very difficult to understand it because it has to be followed by whole country, not our family. We have to be thinking. It is not very easy to make a law for a country. It is very easy to make a law for a school. It is very easy to make a law for a family. Right? But it is very difficult because every people of the particular country has to be follow one law that is made by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. We have to be really proud about his vision and as well as his social justice and as well as his clear perception regarding knowledge. And also a vision which was sought to infuse into the new Indian polity. Yes, a vision which was sought to be infused into the Indian polity. See, if I want to be make a new team for a particular country, it is not a small matter. It is not a silly matter. When Indian polity, after British India, post-independence, when we got independence, then everything is empty. Then we have to form our own government. It is not a small matter to make a government. But here he had given a different ideas for new Indian polity to form a new government. He had given many ideas. And but above all, this was a tribute to success of Babe Saheb Ambedkar, his own campaign against the social justice. Basically, he is the one who suffered lot. He is the one who suffered lot in the social discrimination. But he made a campaign. He made revolution in the field of social society. He brought social justice in the India, right? Yes. Who could not dreamt that one born in Meher family would one day become not only a law minister but a lawmaker and be hailed as a modern Manu? You never believed it. Nobody dreamt it. There was a person who took birth in a Meher family. Here Meher refers Dalit. Word Dalit is infused or introduced by British, which called Mahatma Gandhiji as the Dalit, as a Harijanas. So nobody dreamt that there was a person who born in the Meher family become a law minister, not only law minister, even a law maker. Now he hailed as a great modern Manu. I think you know about Manu. He had a great knowledge of politics and as well as the future categories. We have to be remembering him. He was now considered as a modern Manu, right? I hope you got all these points, right? Okay. Okay, children, we will continue this session in next class. Thank you.